Good morning, students. Today we will study employee stock option plan. Now, what is this employee stock option plan? Basically, it is a type of share based payment. Now, what is share based payment? Sometimes, what happens? Suppose I am buying something from someone. I am buying certain goods. And instead of giving cash, I am giving my own entity's share. So this is a type of share based payment. Same is the case happens when you take services of employee. So instead of giving them cash, you give them company's share, that is employee stock option plan. So what is employee stock option plan? Employee stock option plan is a type of share based payment. There are other types of share based payment as well that we will discuss, but first let us discuss employee stock option plan. So if someone asks me, sir, what is employee stock option plan? It's a type of share based payment, right? What happens in share based payment? You buy goods, you avail services, and instead of giving cash, you give them your own entity share, right? So start writing with me. Point number one. What is ESOP? First of all, it is a type of share based, it is a type of share based payment for goods and services supplied to the entity, right? So instead of giving cash, you are giving your own entity share. Now, what is this employee stock option plan? Basically, it is a contract between entity and its employee. Right? So I'm writing the notes in point form. It will be easy for you to memorize. Now, what is this contract all about? Contract gives employees of the entity the right but not obligation. Now the employee has an option. He may not, right? So this is a contract between entity and its employee. This contract gives employee of the entity the right but not the obligation to purchase or subscribe specified number of shares of the entity at a fixed price. Right? So there are a lot of things that needs to be understood, right? So first, so I have told you what is ESOP. ESOP is a type of share based payment. There are other types of share based payment as well, right? That we will discuss as we progress. Now, what is this share-based payment all about? You buy goods, you buy services, you avail services. Instead of paying cash, you settle in shares. Second, it's a contract between entity. I'm talking about the ESOP, right? I'm not talking about other aspects of other types of share-based payment. I'm only talking about this particular type of share-based payment. It's a contract between entity and its employee. So what is written in this contract, right? It gives employee the right but not the obligation, right? What is the right all about? That they can purchase or subscribe the shares, specified number of shares, that is also predetermined. The price is also predetermined. Now, what is this price? This price is known as exercise price. And this exercise price is much lower than the market price. Now, why the company wants to go for this type of option plan? Basically, if any company is issuing its shares at a price less than the market price, it's a loss to the company. But there are certain categories of employees which the company wants to retain. So the company wants to give up a type of perquisite, a type of benefit. In taxation subject, you might have learned perquisite value of ESOP. So basically, it's a type of benefit which the company wants to give to its employee. And this type of benefit given by the entity to the employee helps the company to retain the employees, right? So basically, it's a contract, right? I've already told you. Number one, right? It gives employees right but not obligation to purchase what? Specified number of shares at a fixed price. Right? So, right, specified number of shares at fixed price. Now, this fixed price is known as exercise price. Is that fine? Okay. Now, sir, there has to be certain conditions, right, upon which the employee can exercise this right, right? The employee has to serve certain number of years in the entity to exercise such option. Say, for example, the company says that minimum 3 years you have to stay in this company. If 3 years you serve this company, then I'm going to give you ESOP. And ESOP means the employee gets the right to buy specified number of shares at a fixed price. And that price is much less than the market price. Right? Now, there is one more term. The period during which employee can exercise the option is known as exercise period. Right? The above period starts when the conditional period of employment is served. I mean to say, when the vesting period is over, the employee has to serve certain number of years in the entity to exercise such option. And this time period is known as vesting period. This is known as vesting period. right? Is that fine? So what is ESOP? It's a type of share-based payment. Now, what is share-based payment? You buy goods, you avail services, and instead of paying in cash, you give your own entity share. So what is ESOP? It's a contract between entity and its employee, and I've already explained to you why the company follows this type of plan, right? It acts as a retention plan, right? There are certain employees which the organization wants to retain, because whenever an employee joins, there is a lot of training, right? Training cost which the company bears, and if that particular employee leaves after 6 months, 8 months, then it's again the company has to hire a new one. So generally, a company, in order to retain employees, they give this type of benefit, right, to employees, so that the employees also stay in order to get avail that benefit. So it's a contract between entity and its employee. The contract is about the right, not the obligation, right? What is this right all about? That the employee can purchase specified, that is also predetermined. The price is also predetermined, and this price is much, 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 much less than the market price. Now the employee has to serve in order to avail this right, in order to have this option, right, to be exercised. The employee has to serve certain number of years in the entity to exercise this option. That is known as vesting period, and this is commonly known as continuous period of employment. He has to serve, say, 3 years, 4 years, whatever. Now the period during which the option can be exercised is known as exercise period, and this period starts when the conditional period of employment is being served, means the vesting period is over. Now, what I will do, I will just, through example number one, through question number one, I will try to explain you what accounting treatments we have to do. Now, you can see that it's a benefit for the employee, right? On the other hand, we are doing accounting for companies. So, what about company, right? For company point of view, it is an expense. And this type of expense is usually classified under the head salaries. It's a benefit, it's a perquisite, right? You have learned income tax. So perquisite is usually comes under the head salary. So this type of expense, right, the company should record under the head salary. That is employee benefit expenses. Anyway, so what I will do, you just read question number one, and through that particular question, we will make you understand the entire process. So question number one. Just go through once. Just kindly go through once. Okay. So, a company grants 1,000 option to its employees on 1st April 2016 at 60. So, April 2016. Right? This is grant date of option. Option has only the right, not the obligation. Right? So, what is the number of options that this particular employee can purchase? 1,000 shares. At what price? Exercise price is 60. Now the vesting period is 2.5 years. It means the employee can only exercise this option, right? Only after 2.5 years. Only after 2.5 years of continuous period of employment. I told you, the employee has to serve. The employee has to serve certain number of years in the entity to exercise such option. And this is known as vesting period. That is also known as continuous period of employment, right? So for 2.5 years, you have to serve. So this is 31st of March 17. This is 31st of March. March 2018, एंड देन 30th of September. March 17, then March 31, and then 30th September 18. So this 2.5 years, this is vesting period. Right? So this 30th September 2018 is also known as vesting date. Right? Now, the maximum exercise period is 1 year. So till 30th September 19, you have to take your decisions. Till 30th September 19, right, you have to take your decisions that whether you want to exercise this option or not. So this particular time period is known as exercise period. Now you will understand that, say for example, that employee has served 2.5 years. After 2.5 years and till further 1 year, the employee can exercise this right. Now, why it is not an obligation? Because suppose in the question it is given that market price as on this date is 90. So you can easily see that I am getting 1000 share purchase option and the straight away my profit is 30 rupees. 90 is the market price, the company is offering me at 60, and as the time progresses, when the company will grow, the share price will also grow. So today my profit is 30, but after 2 year, 3 year down the line, I can have a massive profit. Think the other side. What if the market price comes down to 40? So in that case, in no way you are going to exercise this option. So that is why it is a right, not an obligation. Are you getting my point? As the time progresses down the line, the market price is going to improve. That is what the objective is all about. But there can be an opposite case also. The market price is not improving, it is deteriorating day by day. So in that case, what happens? I am getting two types of indication. When market price is decreasing year after year, it means that the company is not growing. Even if I survive for 2.5 years, then also I will not exercise this option. I know I have the right, but why would I go for it? If the market price is 40, why would I purchase the things at 60? I can easily go to the market and purchase at 40. So that is why it has been said that it is an option. It is not an obligation. Right? It has only right, no obligation attached. Is that fine? But in this case, assuming that all options were exercised on 31st of December 18. So what has happened? That on 31st of December 18, between this exercise period, option has been exercised. Is that fine? So things are pretty clear to me, right? It's a contract where I have the right, no obligation, right? In order to exercise this right, I have to serve the vesting period, right? And only after this vesting period, I get the option to purchase specified number. Why specified number? Because it is predetermined how many options I am going to get. 1000 share purchase option. At a fixed price, because that price is also determined initially. Right? So on 1st April 2016, this option was given by my entity to the employee. That serve us for 2.5 years continuously. After 2.5 years, and from there till 1 year, you get an option that you can purchase 1,000 shares at the rate 60. If the market price is well more, I'll go for it. If the market price has decreased, I couldn't go for it. Right? Now, so what accounting treatment are we talking about? First of all, while we do this practical problem, we will assume that this market price is going to remain constant. Right? Let us assume that the market price is not going to change. Okay. So 90 is the share price currently. Company is offering me at 60. So straight away, after 2.5 years, I can have a profit of 30 per share. And for the company, it is a loss. So what do you think that when the company should recognize this loss? When such option is exercised? Or over the vesting period? Right? So there are a lot of accounting treatments which is followed globally. But as far as our accounting norms as being, our guidance has been concerned, what we are going to do, we can easily see that it's an clear case of 30 rupees benefit for employee, right? And for company, it's a expense, because 90 rupees share company has to offer it at 60. So as per our accounting principles, what we will be doing, we will recognize this 30 as expense. When? Option 1, I can show this expense, entire expense, on the grant date. That being too much of conservatism, that you are recognizing entire 30 as expense on a grant date. However, that liability will occur only after the vesting period, right? Second, that you can show this 30 as expense only when the option is being exercised, right, on 31st of December 2018. Third, you can show this 30 as expense over the vesting period, because this is the conditional period of employment, and for this 2.5 years of service, the employee is going to get this benefit. So what I will do, I will split this 30, which is income for employee, but I am doing accounting for company. For company, it is an expense. So this 30 rupees, basically I am paying for this 2.5 years. After 2.5 years, what can happen? The employee can exercise the option and may leave the organization. Your binding, in order to get this option, the binding is only 2.5 years. Immediately after 2.5 years, I just exercise the right, sold the shares and all, and I gave the resignation. There is a possibility. So instead of showing it on grant date, instead of showing this as expense on exercise date, what we will be doing, basically I am giving this 30 benefit to the employee for this vesting period. Right? So our accounting principles, as per our accounting standards, our guidance note, what we will be doing, we will be recognizing this 30. Anyway, he will be giving me 60 rupees for the share. The benefit is 30. Right? So this is known as employee compensation expense. Right? Is that fine? So, can anyone tell me what is the value of this option? Right? It is also known as fair value. Many call it as intrinsic value. In real life, this value is determined on lot of factors. Market price keeps on changing, but we have assumed that the market price is being constant. For the time value of money will also be considered, that the option granted is today and the exercise will be after 2.5 years. So there's an option pricing model, but that is not there in our curriculum. That's a different subject, options, right? Derivatives. But simply in accounting terms, it will be market price minus EP. So market price on grant date is 90 and EP is 60. So the value of option is 30. To be recognized as expense over vesting period. To be recognized as expense over vesting period. Is that fine? So, what will be the expense for 31st of March 2017? Right? Basically, simple is number of options into value of option divided by vesting period. Right. So number of option is 1000. Okay. 30 rupees is the value of option. So the total amount to be expensed is 30,000 divided by 2.5 years. Right. So how much is expense to be shown in the very first year? $12,000. Then how much will be expense for 31st March 18? Same. $12,000. We are spreading it out. And how much will be expense for 30th September 18? Basically, this is year 1, this is year 2, this is year 3. Half year, right? So it will be 6,000. So this is like for full year. This is also for full year. And this is for half year. So one share, the total loss to the company is 30. For 1000 shares, it will be 30,000. Just spread it over the vesting period. Right? I guess this is absolutely fine with all of you. Clear? So let us start the journal entries. Journal entries, right? And we are doing it in the books of company, right? In the books of company. So this 30,000 to be expensed over 2.5 years, that the very first year expense will be 12,000, right? So I've told you that the company will show it under the head salaries, right? It's a type of salary payment only. So that is to be shown as expense under the head employee compensation expense. So on 31st of March 2017, employee compensation expense debit 12,000 to. Now you are creating a provision, right? Right now the option has not yet been exercised. It will be exercised after 2.5 years. So you are going to create provision, right? So that is the provision account name in this case is employee stock option outstanding. Employee stock option outstanding being expenses amortized over 2.5 year, right? So we are creating simply a provision, right, as per conservatism. So one option was show entire 30 on grant date, show entire 30 as expense on the date of exercise, right? And the third way is you can split it. So we split it over the vesting period, because that is the period of retention, and for that period we are showing this expense, right? So it's employee compensation expense account debit, that is basically salaries. Two, we created a liability. This is what? A liability account. Is that fine? So now on the very same date, profit and loss account debit to employee compensation expense. Is that fine? So it is like salary and type of outstanding, you can say salary account debit to outstanding salary, we know, because this outstanding salary to be paid only after 2.5 years, right? And then salary I have debited it to PL. Now similarly I will do it for next year, the same journal entries will follow. March 31st, 2018, again same thing, employee compensation expense debit 12 to employee stock option outstanding account, right? And then 31st March 2018, profit and loss account debit to employee compensation expense. So as of now, if someone asks me what is the total liability already created, in the very first year the liability created was 12, and it keeps on accumulating, right? So that at the end of 2.5 years, the liability created is 30,000 in my books, right? So in the very first year, the liability created was 12. You can easily see the liability created was 12. Again, I have created a liability for 12. Right, so already 24,000 liability has been created. Now 30th September 18. Now I'll show it for half year. Employee compensation expense debit 6,000 to employee stock option outstanding 6. I'll show this on the debit of PL. Though I will prepare PL at the end of the year, right? You can show it on 31st March as well. So the benefit which the employee will get on exercising the option, that the company has shown as liability over 2.5 years. So you can have a look. 12 liability. Second year again it's 12 more, then it's 6. Provision created, liability shown. Now in the very from here till another 1 year. From 30th September, this is the vesting date, right? This is vesting date, and from here 1 year is the exercise period, means till 30th September 2019 the employee can exercise, and employee has exercised it this year itself, right? On 31st of December. Full option has been exercised, right? So 31st of December 2018. So now bank account debit. Anyway, I'm going to receive 1,000 options 60 per share. This I'll receive anyway. And I have to give from my pocket 30. That was the value of option, right? On grant date. Right? And I told you in real life, market price keeps on changing, but I have assumed it's constant. Further, this option value is determined based on time value of money. So these things have not been considered that you are going to learn in derivative. It's an altogether different subject, financial management. Right? So simply it's the market price minus exercise price is this value of option, right? So this 30 has already been recognized as expense over 3 years, and the liability has been created. So 60 I'll take, 1,000 into 60 I'll take it from employee, and employee stock option outstanding. One thousand into 30, which has already been shown over 2.5 years, that I'll give it from my pocket. So 90 is collected, 30 I gave, 60 collected. So total 90 benefit, right? Total 90. Now, so share as being issued for 90 rupees. Now, what is the face value of share? 10. So if the shares are issued for more than the face value, so you know what you have to do. So under the head equity share capital, 1,000 into 10. Anything collected above par value goes to securities premium. राइट. सो द टोटल प्रोसीड इज 90, 10 गोज टू कैपिटल एंड 80 द पावर वैल्यू गोज टू कैपिटल. इट डजेंट मैटर हु गेव, एम्प्लॉई गेव और एंटिटी गेव, द टोटल प्रोसीड इज 90. 30 आई शोड एज एक्सपेंस ओवर द वेस्टिंग पीरियड एंड 60 आई कलेक्टेड. सो टोटल इज 90. सो 10 विल गो टू द कैपिटल अकाउंट एंड 80 विल गो टू सिक्योरिटीज प्रीमियम अकाउंट. सो दिस इज हाउ वी हैव टू डू इट. सो थ्रू आउट द वेस्टिंग पीरियड दिस विल बी शोन एज एक्सपेंस इन पीएल, राइट. एंड अंडर द बैलेंस शीट दिस एम्प्लॉय स्टॉक ऑप्शन आउटस्टैंडिंग विल बी शोन एज अ लाइबिलिटी. So on vesting date, the entire 30,000 has been expensed and provision has been created, right? Just for your purpose, I'm just showing you one thing. Total accumulated balance in employee stock option outstanding account is equals to 12 plus 12 plus 6. That is 30,000, right? So this is how we do accounting in case of employee stock option plan, right? In our very next session, we will be covering few more questions. Till then, goodbye. Take care.